My name, Professor Ahmed Wafa, Professor of Cardiology, Mansoura University. Today, I will talk to you with the new guidelines of the European Society of Cardiology for management of heart failure. And you know, heart failure is the leading cause of death worldwide. Heart failure is the final pathway for all cardiovascular diseases as hypertension, ischemic heart disease, cardiomyopathy, congenital heart disease, valvular heart disease, or can lead to heart failure. Heart failure has high incidence and prevalence all over the world. And so the European Society of Cardiology and the American College of Cardiology developed the new guidelines for management of heart failure. They classify heart failure into three categories. Heart failure with reduced ejection fraction, when echocardiography shows that ejection fraction is less than 40%. Heart failure with preserved ejection fraction, when the ejection fraction is more than 50%, and there is symptoms of heart failure, and heart failure with mid-range ejection fraction, when the ejection fraction between 40 to 49%. Also, they are concentrated on the different imaging modalities and the different laboratory modalities for diagnosis of the type of heart failure, especially echocardiography and prenatal uretic peptide. Also, very important, the line of treatment of heart failure, which include mainly the RAS blocker plus beta blocker. And if the patient is congested in the form of dyspnea, edema, lower limb, orthopnea, diuretics are very important. If the patient is still symptomatic after this, we can add spironolactone is very important for treatment. And if the patient is still symptomatic and the heart rate is more than 70%, and in sinus rhythm, here come the rule for evobradine. If the patient is having a left bundle branchial block specially and the QRS complex is wide, here come the rule for CRT. If the patient is still symptomatic in spite of all this measure, here come the rule for invasive management like surgery for revascularization and lastly cardiac transplantation. So these guidelines are very important for every physician, not only the cardiologist, because heart failure, as I mentioned, is the final common pathway for all cardiovascular disease. And thank you.